In the previous video, we looked at momentary or unlatched macro trigger from a user-defined key. This time, let's create a macro with latched behavior, where functions can be turned on with one press and off with the next press. Let's use the virtual sound check function as an example. It's normally enabled and disabled from the recording patch screen in the patch menu, but now we can create a macro for it to avoid the need to navigate screens. Though, to get the latching behavior, we're not going to use the user-defined key itself as the trigger, but we are going to use the switch's LED. So first we shall create a macro for the LED to have a latched behavior. Create a new macro in the macro list. Touch its title and name it UDK1LED. Open the capture list and press the user-defined key number 1. Keep it held and import it as a trigger before releasing the key. Now, create a new action and choose user-defined as the category. Then choose keys as function 1, LED as function 2, and state as function 3. Select the correct user-defined key bank and key number. Set the operator to toggle and then enable the macro. See that the user-defined key now toggles its LED on and off each time it is pressed. So now we can create the virtual sound check macro with the user-defined key's LED as the trigger. So create a new macro and call it VSC. Enable capture and switch on the virtual sound check using the other screen. Import that into the action list. Now press the user-defined key and select the LED state on item and import that into the trigger list. Before enabling the macro, we need to create the reverse action for disabling virtual sound check. So touch the action reverse action button and copy the action. Select it for editing and change the value to off. Enable the macro and check that it works as expected. Next, let's create a dynamic label and color bar for the user-defined keys so it can visually inform us of the VSC status. For this, we need to create some additional actions and reverse actions. Let's start with the actions. Turn off the macro and add a new action. Select user-defined as the category, then select keys as function 1, label as function 2, color as function 3. Check the correct user-defined key is targeted, so bank D number 1 in this case, and use the value field to choose the color. I shall go for red to indicate VSC is active. Add another action for the label text. Again, User define key as the category, keys as function one, label as function two, name as function three, and title is function four. Again, make sure the correct bank and key number is selected. This time, in the value field, we can type a title. VSC is enough for me. Now, duplicate this item and edit it. This time, choosing line as function 4. There are three lines of text to choose from, though I only need line 1 here. In the value field, I shall simply type on. Let's enable a macro and see how it looks. So, that is good, but we also want an off indication. So let's create some more reverse actions. Disable the macro again. Select the reverse action list and create a new item. Remember, select user define as the category, keys as function one, label as function two, color as function three. And of course, bank D, key number one. Then let's make the value go green when VSC is off. Duplicate that item and edit it for the label, name, and line function. Then type off as the value. Enable the macro and let's check its behavior. Yes, it is working well. Though, it could be risky having the function so easily available during a live show. Let's add a condition so the switch is only enabled under certain conditions. How about we only allow it to work when the main stereo fader is below minus 60 dB. This will avoid any sudden changes in sound from the PA system. Though we should add the condition to the LED macro to avoid the LED coming on in the first place when the fader is up. So select that macro, disable it, open capture and move the stereo A fader to around minus 60 dB and import this item into the condition list. Close capture and edit the item. Change the operator from equal to less than. Then you can edit the value for finer adjustment if you wish. Enable a macro and test. That is working well now. So that's another completed example of how to program your own macros in Genius Lab, found in RIVAGE PM version 6 and higher. Don't miss the previous Genius Lab videos about using function keys, wait times, and more. In the next session, we'll look in more detail about using faders as triggers. See you soon. Thank you.